This video presents some practical expressions examples to use when working with expression-defined properties. The first example is the definition of a constant. This constant will be the golden ratio, which has been used in design since the ancient times. Its data type will be number and will be available for all classification values. The formula of the golden ratio is to add 1 to the square root of 5 and divide the result by 2. We will need to use the square root function to calculate the square root. The sum of 1 plus the square root of 5 must be placed into parentheses so that they are added first, and then their sum is divided by 2. This golden ratio property can then later be used in other property expressions. The second example will calculate the illumination factor of zones, the ratio between the glass surfaces of a zone's windows and the area of the zone. The data type of the property will be number and will be available for elements classified as spaces. We do this by taking the total surface area of the zone's windows, multiplying it by a window glazing ratio that takes into consideration how much of the window surface is actually glass, and dividing the result by the area of the zone. The window glazing ratio is another property that stores the ratio as a constant number. It is currently set to a value of 0.85, and it can be easily modified as conditions change. The expression will be the following. The window surface area property available for zones multiplied by the window glazing ratio then divided by the calculated area of the zone. The parentheses in this case are optional, since the expression will give the same result with or without the parentheses. The third example is a door info tag, which displays information about the door's element ID, home story number, and orientation. It will be used in an auto text label associated to doors. The property's data type will be string, and it will be available for elements classified as doors. We will use the concat function to concatenate these values. The values to be included must be separated by commas. The string consists of the element ID, a slash character, the home story number, which returns a numeric value, so it needs to be converted to a string. For this, we will use the str function. Another slash character. And finally, the orientation. If we now use the property in an auto text label, we can see that it returns the correct value of the property in the correct format for each door. The fourth example is a property, the value of which is true if a wall has no doors, windows, or any other openings in it. The data type of the property will be true/false and will be available for elements classified as walls. To achieve this, we will use the if function. Three conditions must be met for the if function to return the true value. We will use the AND operator to test for each of these three conditions. The three conditions are: the number of doors in the wall must be 0. The number of windows in the wall must be 0. And the number of empty openings in the wall must be 0. If all three conditions are true, then the value of the property will be true. In any other case, it will be false. To check how the property works, we can close the dialog by clicking OK to accept changes, select a wall with no openings, select another with a door, window, or opening in it, and return to the Property Manager dialog. If we click the Evaluate button, the value of the property will be evaluated for the selected elements. Correctly, the property value is true for the first wall and false for the second one. The fifth and final example calculates the bottom elevation of a slab relative to sea level. There's a parameter called elevation bottom that returns the bottom elevation of a slab, but its value is calculated relative to the project zero. With the clever use of this and other parameters, we can achieve our goal. The data type of the property will be length, and it will be available for elements classified as slabs. To calculate the desired value, we will simply need to take the elevation bottom property, and add it to the difference between the elevation to sea level and elevation to project zero properties. The difference of these two values will give us the amount the sea level is above or below the project zero. With this simple trick, we have achieved what we wanted. If we generate this property in a schedule, we will see that it returns a correct value for slabs, regardless of where the reference plane of the slab is located relative to the body of the slab. Please watch all clips in this playlist to fully familiarize yourself with the capabilities of this new feature of ArchiCAD 22.